Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Flying Beauty. So I know it has been a long since I have posted the last video. It has been 1 week long. So with a request from my subscribers, my friends, so today I'll be talking about how to get yourself prepared for a cabin crew interview. So if you are new to my channel, then welcome to my channel. My name is Vaishali and my channel's name is Flying Beauty. If you are new, then please subscribe to my channel. You can click the bell icon, red color bell icon, ghanti bajao, and so that you get notified first whenever I post any kind of video. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, like, and share it with your friends, with your loved ones, so that they can also take the help from this video. And if you want any kind of improvement or anything, you can comment down below. So without any further ado, let's get started. Foremost thing that I would like to talk about a cabin crew interview is that whenever, for whatever interview you are going, become prepare a mindset that yes, I can do. Because first attempt, if you will think that I don't know if I will clear it or not, if you will fear about the interview, then it will become a lack of confidence within you. So a lack of confidence, it's a very strong negative point of an interviewee. If someone is going for the interview and she or she is going without a lack of confidence for any kind of interview, not only in cabin crew interview or for cabin crew interview, but any kind of job interview, then that's a most negative point. So you have to be very much positive, you have to be confident, so that if anything happens, if you are giving the wrong answer, give it with a confidence, then the interviewer will get or sit down to think that yeah, he or she is giving wrong answer, but still she has the confidence in it. So for cabin crew interview also, you need a confidence so that the interviewer gets a good vibe from you. Alright, so confidence is the first point that you need to have while going for a cabin crew interview. So the second point for a cabin crew interview is that if you are going for a cabin crew interview, you have to groom yourself very properly. Like, you have to follow all the guidelines that has been given to you. Okay, first of all, like your dress or uniform. So for a cabin crew interview, you have to be in formals. Formals as if like you have to wear knee-length skirts, okay, a half-sleeve shirt, okay, a stockings and a pointed heel, closed pointed heels. Let it be like stilettos kind of things or small pumps like that. And the color of the heels that you'll be wearing, it should be either black or some matte finish kind of shoes, like a mauve color, a skin color like that, not, or red also you can wear, but red is very attractive. It attracts in our eyes, okay? It's a very bright color. So I'll be saying that try to avoid that kind of color that are very much like bright for our eyes, okay? Avoid that kind of colors. And for your shirts also, wear very light kind of colors, like a little light pink, or you can wear white, it's very good choice, or sky blue, light sky blue, or a mauve kind of shirt. So this kind of shirts you can wear for a cabin crew interview. And regarding the skirt, it should be knee length, okay? And then you can wear black color skirts for the options that I am giving you for the skirts, black, any skin color or very light kind of color. You can wear also maroon colored skirts. So these are the things for the uniform I have said. So there is a proper uniform that you need to wear for a cabin crew interview. Okay. And along with that, try to wear stockings. Stockings are compulsory for a cabin crew interview. You have to wear stockings along with your uniform, okay? So this is the thing that you need to wear, that's the uniform. Okay, next thing that comes for a cabin crew interview is your makeup. Okay, true makeup that should be minimal amount. Like you should be having a good eyebrow. You should be making a good eyebrow, then liner, lipstick. Okay, so wear a good nail polish. Color can be a new one, a red one, something like that. That looks good on you. Okay, and for lipstick also you can wear red. Okay, red is a good color option for the lipstick for going for a cabin crew interview. Okay, and regarding the hair, you make a clean, neat bun. Okay, bun looks very good on a uniform for the cabin crew interview. All right, so hair should be neat and clean if you are also making a bun. Okay, and if you have short hair like me, then you can do like you can straighten up your hairs, okay, before going. Okay, apply good serum for your hair so that it looks clean and tidy. Okay, not like a haphazard one, or it doesn't look good if you're going like a very dirty kind of looks, like your hairs are coming out, okay, and it's running here and then, it looks very untidy and unprofessional also. So you have to look good, because in cabin crew interview, alright, looks does matter, because a cabin crew should be looking good to attract passengers or customers, so that if an airline is hiring you, okay, a cabin crew is the front face by looking at which a customer comes. Okay, so you have to be in proper grooming so that it attracts the customer, it attracts the passengers so that they come again and again. And that's a one point that the interviewer looks in a candidate, okay, for a cabin crew interview. Alright, so makeup should be at point, okay, lipstick, choice of eyeshadow, your liner, your eyebrows, okay, blusher, okay. So these are the things regarding the makeup. Next thing is some body languages, okay? So body language is also a thing that an interviewer sees in a candidate during a cabin crew interview. Your body language should be very positive, okay? It shouldn't look very lethargic, like that yes, I have come from the interview, and it shouldn't look like you are having a fear of interview. No, I can't do it. No, what will happen? Will I get selected or not? No, this kind of body language shows that you are having a lack of confidence. You have a fear. Okay, so wherever you are going, or whenever you are going for a interview or a cabin crew interview, go with a good positive language. Okay, always have a smile on your face, because my friends, a smile can attract anyone. If you have a good smile on your face, okay, then you can attract anyone. Let it be an interviewer also. Alright, so a smile, a good body language are the key points for an interview, for any kind of interview. Always wear your smile. Even if you are having any kind of tension, and if you are wearing a smile on your face, nobody can understand that you are going through a rough phase, okay, or any bad kind of thing behind your mind. Oh, so a smile is a key. Like if you are having smile, okay, a interviewer will think that yes, the girl is confident. A smile also proves that or signifies your confidence, okay. So always have a smile in your face, and especially for the cabin crew interview, smile is a key point. Because without a smile, like I am smiling right now, if I stop smiling like this, am I looking good? So if I start talking to you guys like this, hello friends, welcome back to my channel, today I'll be talking about this thing, am I looking good? No. Okay, so you have always smile. If you can smile, you can conquer the world, guys. Seriously, girls, you can conquer the world. Okay, smile is a main attraction. It also attracts other people towards you. So keep a good body language, keep a good smile, wear your confidence. These are the key points that you need to go for a cabin crew interview. Okay, another most thing that one needs to get prepared is for a good communication skill. An interviewer will check your communication skill. Okay, if you are mainly in English and Hindi. Okay, you have to be good in Hindi and English. So for English, okay, what you can do to grow up your speaking power, like you can watch good English movies, you can read newspapers, storybooks, any kind of storybooks that you like, fictional, love story, detective, murder, thriller, ghost, any kind of storybooks, whatever you want, okay, you can like read any kind of storybooks, okay, it helps to learn more words, it enhances your vocabulary and your speaking power also, okay. So you need to read books, all right, and try to read newspaper also, because newspapers are a very good option to grow up your vocabulary. It enhances your general knowledge also. Like sometimes in the interview, for cabin crew interview, they don't ask you about any current affairs or like that, but they can ask you any questions related to the airlines for which you are going for the interview. All right, so you need to have some proper knowledge about the airline. So these things like comes in newspaper also, okay, that how much this airline is having its share in the industry, in the whole market, global market, what's its success rate, okay, is it the number one airlines in the world, or if you're going for an Indian airlines, like Indian based airlines, then you have to check or know that if this airline is the best airlines for Indian company or for India. Like these are the small things that you need to know about a airlines if you're going for the interview of a specific airlines, okay. And the next thing about Hindi also, so you have to be good in Hindi, okay. You have to learn Hindi, like the same wise I told you about English, you have to be good in Hindi also. For Hindi also, you can watch Hindi movies. We are like Indians and we are fan of Bollywood movies. You can watch Bollywood movies, you can read books if you want, okay. If you know how to read Hindi, then you can listen to Hindi songs also, and for English also you can listen to English songs also, okay. And for Hindi also you can listen to Bollywood songs to enhance your Hindi vocabulary, Hindi speaking powers, okay. So these are the things that you need to have for the friends. Almost I have covered every point that is needed for a cabin crew interview, okay. And one thing that I forgot, that you have to be according to your BMI. Your height and weight should be according to your BMI. You can't be overweight, you can't be underweight also, and you can't have scar marks in your face, no visible scar marks, even not tattoo also, no visible tattoo. Like if you wear your uniform, you can't have any visible tattoo that can be shown above the uniform. If you have tattoos, it should be covered, okay, behind the uniform, it should not be visible, okay. Your eyesight should have be good, okay. Your hearing capability should be good, and speaking power, I have already told you about this thing, okay. And there shouldn't be any burn marks, cut marks, scar marks in your face or in your whole body. No inking in your body, like visible parts. Okay, I have already covered every points. Okay, so last but not the least, wear your confidence and go to the interview with your full smile, full on power, and full on smile, so that if you go for the interview in one go, you get selected and come back, okay. So all the best to all my dear friends and candidates who are preparing for a cabin crew interview, okay. Best of luck, and even if you don't get selected, don't lose hope, okay, because once a man like my father has told me, this failure is a pillar of success. Even I have also failed many times, okay, before appearing for the cabin crew interview, but at last I got selected, okay. So please wear your smile, go with the confidence, okay? I know you will all do the best. So guys, that's all for this video. I hope you liked the video, and if you have liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. Comment down below that which topic you want me to make the video next. Alright, subscribe to the bell button, hit the bell button, ghanti bajao, and get the notifications whenever I post any kind of such video. Keep loving me, keep showing your love to me, keep sharing your blessings to me so that I get motivation and make more and more videos for you. Okay, love you guys. Till then, bye.